The Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and recite the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Head Priest Gianni Damrevere Singh of the Sikh Cultural Society of South Richmond Hill, New York, will deliver today's invocation.
ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ ਪ੍ਰਥਮ ਭਗਵਤੀ ਸਿਮਰ ਕੈ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਲਈ ਧਿਆਏ ਫਿਰ ਅੰਗਦ ਗੁਰ ਤੇ ਅਮਰਦਾਸ ਰਾਮਦਾਸੈ ਹੋਈ ਸਹਾਏ ਅਰਜਨ ਹਰ ਗੋਬਿੰਦ ਨੋ ਸਿਮਰੋ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਹਰਿ ਰਾਏ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਹਰਿ ਕ੍ਰਿਸ਼ਨ ਧਿਆਈ ਹੈ ਜਿਸ ਡਿਠੈ ਸਭ ਦੁੱਖ ਜਾਏ ਤੇਗ ਬਹਾਦਰ ਸਿਮਰੈ ਘਰ ਨੋ ਨਿਧ ਆਵੈ ਤਹਾਏ ਸਭ ਥਾਈਂ ਹੋਏ ਸਹਾਏ ਦਸਵੇਂ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਗੋਬਿੰਦ ਸਿੰਘ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਸਭ ਥਾਈਂ ਹੋਏ ਸਹਾਏ ਦਸਾਂ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹੀਆਂ ਦੀ ਜੋਤ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਗ੍ਰੰਥ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੇ ਪਾਠ ਦੀਦਾਰ ਦਾ ਧਿਆਨ ਧਰ ਕੇ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਜੀ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਬੋਲੋ ਜੀ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਹੇ ਨਿਮਾਣਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਮਾਣ ਨਿਤਾਣਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਤਾਣ ਨੇ ਉਟਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਓਠ ਨੇ ਆਸਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਆਸਰਾ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਿਤਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਧੰਨ ਧੰਨ ਹਾਜ਼ਰ ਨਾਜ਼ਰ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਗ੍ਰੰਥ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਆਪ ਜੀ ਦੀ ਅਪਾਰ ਅਪਾਰ ਬਖਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਮਿਹਰਾਮਤ ਹੋਈ ਹੈ ਦਸ਼ਮੇਸ਼ ਪਿਤਾ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਗੋਬਿੰਦ ਸਿੰਘ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੀਆਂ ਬੇਅੰਤ ਬਖਸ਼ਿਸ਼ਾਂ ਮਨੁੱਖਤਾ ਅਤੇ ਮਾਨਵਤਾ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਦੀਆਂ ਕੀਤੀਆਂ ਹੋਈਆਂ ਰਹਿਮਤਾਂ ਜੋ ਸੰਨ 1699 ਦੀ ਵਿਸਾਖੀ ਨੂੰ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਕੇਸਗੜ੍ਹ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਦੀ ਧਰਤੀ 'ਤੇ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਅਨੰਦਪੁਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਦੀ ਧਰਤੀ 'ਤੇ ਜੋ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਨੇ ਵਿਸਾਖੀ ਵਾਲੇ ਦਿਨ ਖਾਲਸੇ ਦੀ ਸਿਰਜਣਾ ਕੀਤੀ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਦੀ ਅਪਾਰ ਬਖਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਸਦਕਾ ਸਾਰੇ ਸੰਸਾਰ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਲ ਵਰਲਡ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਸਿੱਖ ਕੌਮ ਔਰ ਸਿੱਖ ਇਜ਼ਮ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਦੀ ਕਿਰਪਾ ਸਦਕਾ ਅਤੇ ਸਦਾ ਬੇਅੰਤ ਪ੍ਰਚਾਰ ਪ੍ਰਸਾਰ ਸ਼ਾਨੋ ਸ਼ੌਕਤ ਅਣਖ ਗੈਰਤ ਅਤੇ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀ ਕਲਾ ਨਾਲ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਪੰਥ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦਾ ਚਲਾਇਆ ਨਿਰਮਲ ਪੰਥ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀ ਕਲਾ ਨਾਲ ਗੁਰੂ ਕੇ ਸਿੱਖ ਵੱਸ ਰਹੇ ਹਨ ਗੁਰੂ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੀ ਅਪਾਰ ਬਖਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਮਿਹਰਾਮਤ ਹੋਈ ਹੈ ਨਿਊਯਾਰਕ ਦੀ ਸੈਨੇਟ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਜੀ ਦੀ ਕਿਰਪਾ ਸਦਕਾ ਜੋ ਐਲਬਨੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੈ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਨੇ ਕਿਰਪਾ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੈ ਸਮੁੱਚੀ ਸੈਨੇਟ ਵੱਲੋਂ ਜੋ ਅਪ੍ਰੈਲ ਮੰਥ ਅਤੇ ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਸਿੱਖ ਅਵੇਅਰਨੈਸ ਮੰਥ ਦਾ ਐਲਾਨ ਕੀਤਾ ਜਾ ਰਿਹਾ ਹੈ ਮਤਾ ਪਾਸ ਹੋਇਆ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਜੀ ਬਖਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਨ ਸਮੁੱਚੀ ਸੈਨੇਟ ਨੂੰ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀਆਂ ਕਲਾ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਆਉਣ ਵਾਲੇ ਸਮੇਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਮਨੁੱਖਤਾ ਮਾਨਵਤਾ ਦੀ ਸੇਵਾ ਕਰਨ ਦਾ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਬਲ ਦੇਣ ਔਰ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਪੰਥ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦਾ ਚਲਾਇਆ ਨਿਰਮਲ ਪੰਥ ਸਿੱਖ ਕੌਮ ਸਾਰੇ ਦੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਸੰਸਾਰ ਜਗਤ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਭਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀਆਂ ਕਲਾ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਸੰਗਤਾਂ ਵਿਚਰਦੀਆਂ ਰਹਿਣ ਔਰ ਸਿੱਖ ਕੌਮ ਔਰ ਗੁਰੂ ਕੇ ਸਿੱਖ ਸੰਸਾਰ ਭਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਹਰ ਖਿੱਤੇ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਹਰ ਕੰਮਕਾਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀਆਂ ਕਲਾ ਨਾਲ ਤਰੱਕੀਆਂ ਕਰਦੇ ਰਹਿਣ ਝੂਲ 'ਤੇ ਨਿਸ਼ਾਨ ਰਹੇ ਪੰਥ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਕੇ ਲਾਗ 'ਤੇ ਦੀਵਾਨ ਰਹੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਕੇ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਸੱਚੇ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਆਉਣ ਵਾਲੇ ਸਮੇਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਪੰਥ ਨੂੰ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀਆਂ ਕਲਾ ਬਖਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਕੇ ਨਿਵਾਜ਼ੀ ਰੱਖਣ ਔਰ ਐਸੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਪਿਆਰਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਆਉਣ ਵਾਲੇ ਸਮੇਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਪੰਥਕ ਸੇਵਾਵਾਂ ਕਰਨ ਦਾ ਹੋਰ ਬਲ ਬਖਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਨ ਸਹੀ ਪਿਆਰੇ ਮੇਲ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਮਿਲਿਆ ਤੇਰਾ ਨਾਮ ਚੇਤੇ ਆਵੇ ਨਾਨਕ ਨਾਮ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀ ਕਲਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਭਾਣੇ ਸਰਬੱਤ ਦਾ ਭਲਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ ਬੋਲੇ ਸੋ ਨਿਹਾਲ ਦੇਗ ਤੇਗ ਫਤਿਹ ਪੰਥ ਕੀ ਜੀਤ ਪੰਥ ਕੀ ਰਾਜ ਕਰੇਗਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ
Reading of the journal.
In Senate, Saturday, April 22nd, 2023, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Friday, April 21st, 2023, was read and approved. On motion, the Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions, messages from the Assembly, messages from the Governor, reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers. Motions and resolutions. Senator Gianaris.
Good morning, Madam President. I wish to call up the following bills which were recalled from the Assembly and are now at the desk. Senate Bill 608A and Senate Bill 636.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 77, Senate Print 608A by Senator Salazar. An act to amend the general business law. Calendar number 174, Senate Print 636 by Senator Comrie. An act to amend the business corporation law and the limited liability company law.
Move to reconsider the vote by which these bills were passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Cougar, Ortsrud, Cousins, White, aye 55.
The bills are restored to their place on the third reading calendar.
I offer the following amendments.
The amendments are received and the bills will retain their place on the third reading calendar. Senator Gianaris.
Madam President, just to give my colleagues a sense of the order for the day, we're going to take up a resolution shortly and then break for a Rules Committee meeting, which will produce the budget extender bill, which we will take up. At that point, we will break for party conferences and come back and take up the remaining bill off the supplemental calendar. So let's begin by taking up previously adopted Resolution 751 by Senator Scarsella-Spanton. Read its title and recognize Senator Scarsella-Spanton.
The Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution 7051 by Senator Scarsella-Spanton, memorializing Governor Kathy Hochul, that proclaimed April 2023 as the month of the military child in the state of New York.
Senator Scarsella-Spanton on the resolution.
Thank you, Madam President. Our military families and their children make countless sacrifices to serve our country and keep us safe, and it is essential that we take the time to acknowledge and honor their contributions. Military children face unique challenges as they navigate frequent moves, deployments of their parents, and the stress that comes with having a loved one in harm's way. As myself and Senator Ashby can attest to, military children live a life of constant change. Military families move on average every 2 to 3 years, which causes military children to constantly change schools, make new friends, and adapt to new support networks. In my family's case, my husband deployed to Afghanistan for the second time when our daughter was just 10 days old. Despite these challenges, military children demonstrate remarkable resilience and strength. Moving forward, throughout the month of April, we celebrate military children and express our gratitude for their courage, strength, and sacrifice. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Senator Ashby on the resolution.
Thank you, Madam President. I want to thank the Chairwoman Scarsella-Spanton and my colleagues for bringing this resolution to the floor. And like her and so many families out there, the children of military families endure tremendous sacrifice and are often born into it. Like her family, my daughter Ellie was 6 months old during my first deployment, or my second deployment. My son, who thought it would be better to go on a field trip today rather than come to the chamber, He was just a few weeks old during my first deployment, which, you know, oftentimes we talk about the sacrifices of those who served, and we forget or sometimes overlook the sacrifices of the families. And it's important to remember that. And although our hardships, though we endured, are pale in comparison to those children whose family members, whose parents, whose brothers, whose sisters did not come back. Were unable to come back. And oftentimes, when they do come back, struggle. And it's important for us to remember and recognize the struggles of those families and to do our utmost in this chamber to help them. So again, I want to thank my colleague for all she does as the chairwoman of the Veterans Committee, and thank my colleagues, and thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Senator. The resolution was previously adopted on April 18th. Senator Gianaris.
Madam President, Senator Scarsella-Spanton would like to open this resolution for co-sponsorship.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. Should you choose not to be a co-sponsor on the resolutions, please notify the desk. Senator Gianaris.
There will be an immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332.
There'll be an immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332.
The Senate stands at ease.
The Senate stands at ease. The Senate will return to order. Senator Gianaris.
Madam President, back to motions and resolutions. We're going to now take up previously adopted Resolution 633 by Senator Thomas. Read its title and recognize Senator Thomas.
The Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution 633 by Senator Thomas, memorializing Governor Kathy Hochul to proclaim April 2023 as Sikh Awareness Month in the state of New York.
Senator Thomas on the resolution.
Thank you, Madam President. Sat Sri Akal. Thank you to Gyani Dharmveer Singh from the Richmond Hill Gurdwara in Queens for that prayer, Senator Adabo's district. Once again, today I want to highlight how blessed we are in this great state with our diversity. April is Sikh Heritage and Awareness Month, and this month was chosen because Sikhs celebrate Vaisakhi, which is the birth of the Khalsa. It is a religion founded more than 500 years ago by Guru Nanak, who taught that all paths lead to one God, all people are equal, and we should serve our community without asking for anything in return. Through today's resolution, I want to recognize the many contributions the Sikh Americans have made to our nation and to reflect on the pluralism that is a hallmark of America. Sikhs have a long and rich history here in the United States. As early as the 1800s, Sikh men and women have been making notable contributions to American society. Early settlers played a major role in building America's railroads. Sikh Americans served in the U.S. military during the World Wars, and the first Asian American congressman was a Sikh American elected to office in 1957. Sikhism's principles of equality, service, interfaith cooperation, and respect are principles shared by all Americans. Their faith centers on equality of all humankind and the need for compassion in our service to others, like what we do in this chamber. This month provides an opportunity for all of us to recognize the invaluable contributions of the Sikh community to our state and our nation. The Sikh community in New York is an integral part of our diverse population. They have contributed greatly to our state. Sikh Americans continue to be recognized for their outstanding contributions in various fields, including medicine, law, business, the military, media, and more. That's why I am excited to welcome some special guests today, Harpreet Singh Thur, Mr. Jatinder Singh Boparari, Mr. Bhupinder Singh, Mr. Bhuta Singh, and Mrs. Rajwinder Kaur. Thank you for joining us. However, a sad reality is that Sikhs have also faced discrimination and hate crimes in our country. It is important to stand in solidarity with our Sikh brothers and sisters, denounce hate and bigotry, and work towards a more inclusive society. As we celebrate Sikh Awareness Month, let us take the time to learn about the Sikh religion, its values, and its contributions to our society. Madam President, please recognize my guests in the gallery who have come from all over New York State today to grace us with their presence this morning. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Senator Thomas. Senator Adabo on the resolution.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Madam President. Good afternoon, everybody. I want to thank Senator Thomas for the resolution. Thank you very much. And for my friends who have visited Albany, thank you so much for being here. The Sikh Cultural Society, thank you very much. And obviously, Vandir Singh, Dharmveer Singh, thank you very much for being here, all the way from Richmond Hill. You know, the census doesn't account for religion when they do their census. But the American Community Survey, they account for religion throughout our state. And in our state, there's roughly 27,000 Sikhs living in New York State, 10,000 of which are in my district in Richmond Hill. And we do appreciate their contributions to the community and being a part of our community and community members. The Sikh religion advocates for equality, social justice, service to the community, and tolerance for other religions, which is very important in such a diverse state like ours and in the borough of Queens, the most diverse borough in the world. But also the message of the Sikh religion is freedom of religion, reverence to God, and at times practicing the ideals of honesty, compassion, humility, and generosity. Honesty, compassion, humility, and generosity. No matter what our background is, if we applied those principles to our lives, we would be a far better society and even a better government. Thank you very much, Madam President.
President. I want to thank Senator Addabbo and Senator Thomas for bringing this resolution today. The Sikh community is very prominent in Queens. I've been honored to work with them over the years. For many years, the Sikh Cultural Society has not only been active in making sure that they inform the entire community of their history and religion, but they're also involved in community and civic activities, having been very involved in the pandemic and making sure that people were taken care of, making sure that people were fed, and making sure that people had opportunity for medical services. I'm proud to have a small section of the Sikh community in my new district. I had a larger section in my old district, but I will continue to work with all parts of the Sikh community because it's important that we allow folk to be able to express themselves, that we can do tolerance for each other, make sure that all communities in Queens and throughout New York State get to understand and appreciate each other. Thank you, Madam President, for allowing this resolution to come forward.
Thank you, Senator Conway. Senator Stavisky on the resolution.
Thank you to the senators for recognizing the Sikh community. You notice that we're from Queens. Senator Addabbo and Senator Comrie and I have in common the Sikh community, and we thank them and honor them today. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Senator Stavisky. Senator Kennedy on the resolution.
Thank you, Madam President. I too want to recognize the Sikh leadership for being here today, our friends from the Sikh community, our colleagues for bringing this to the floor, from Senator Thomas from Long Island, Senator Addabbo from Queens. You heard from Senator Comrie and Senator Stavisky, both from Queens. Well, out in Buffalo and Western New York, we also have a thriving Sikh community. I'm proud to represent that Sikh community in my district. The one thing I've learned over many years is the Sikh leadership and the Sikh community represents a community of peace. And these are leaders throughout our community in Western New York and clearly across the state and the nation that are leading both in the community and in business and in helping other people thrive. And so it's with a great honor that I welcome you here to the chamber today. And it's a great pride that I represent the Sikh community in Western New York. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Kennedy. To our guests, I welcome you on behalf of the Senate. We extend to you the privileges and courtesies of the House. Please rise and be recognized. The resolution was previously adopted on April 10th. Senator Gianaris.
Thomas would like to open that resolution for co-sponsorship.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. Should you choose not to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk. Senator Gianaris.
There's a report of the Rules Committee at the desk. Can we take that up, please?
No. Yeah. The Secretary will read.
Senator Stuart Cousin from the Committee on Rules reports the following bills. Senate Print 5889 by Senator Breslin, an act to amend the insurance law. Senate Print 6454, Independent Redistricting Commission, an act to amend the state law. Senate Print 6480 by Senator Krueger, an act making appropriations for the support of government. All bills report direct to third reading.
Move to accept the report of the Rules Committee.
All those in favor of accepting the report of the Rules Committee signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The report of the Rules Committee is accepted. Senator Gianaris.
Please take up the supplemental calendar.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 627, Senate Print 6454, Independent Redistricting Commission, an act to amend the state law.
Is that? No. That's redistricting. The bill is temporarily laid aside.
Calendar number 628, Senate Print 6480 by Senator Krueger, an act making appropriation for the support of government.
Message of necessity and appropriation at the desk.
There's a message of necessity and appropriation at the desk.
Necessity and Appropriation at the desk.
Move to accept the message.
All those in favor of accepting the message, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The message is accepted and the bill is before the House.
Laid aside.
The bill is laid aside. That completes the reading of the calendar. Senator Gianaris.
Can we now go to the controversial calendar, please?
The secretary will ring the bell. The secretary will read.
Calendar number 628, Senate Print 6480 by Senator Krueger, an act making appropriation for the support of government.
Oh, why do you rise?
Why do I rise? Well, it's not to make another Groundhog's Day joke, I can promise you that. Will the sponsor yield for a question?
Senator Krueger, do you yield?
Yes, I will.
Senator, yield.
Thank you. Through you, Madam President. So here we are. I believe this is our fifth budget extender today, if I'm counting correctly. Five. What's the value of today's extender?
Today's extender is worth $4.8 billion and lasts through Friday. Right?
Madam President, will sponsor continue to yield?
Do you continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator, yield.
So almost $5 billion for 4 days. This should be an identifier to the people of New York State exactly what it costs or what our government spends each and every day here in New York State. So for the question is this a straight policy or is this a straight extender? Is there any policy in the budget today?
It's a straight extender. I don't believe there's any policy per se. There is some new money that we haven't seen in previous weeks, I think, for the EPIC program, which is the elderly pharmaceutical, I see. It's coverage. I knew that. Thank you. So there's approximately, what did you say, $8.8 million in this for the money needed for EPIC.
Thank you. Madam President, will sponsor continue to yield?
Do you continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator Krueger, yield.
So this extender will take us through Friday, April 28th. So do we expect to see some budget bills, perhaps even tonight, so that they have time to age and we can vote on them before Friday?
I'm pretty optimistic we will see budget bills. I don't believe we will see any by tonight. You are right about the normal aging process of 3 days, but as you might have noticed, we seem to do budget bills using messages of necessity, which are not an ideal scenario, but perhaps are better than continuing extenders.
Madam President, sponsor, continue to yield.
Do you continue to yield?
Yes.
Does Senator Krueger yield?
So it sounds like things are somewhat improving, we'll say, in the budget negotiation logjam. What's the status of your negotiations right now?
The three leaders have been continuing to meet, and the secretaries have been continuing to meet, and everybody, I think, feels that we are making progress. Some policy issues that the governor put in her original budget are, I don't know if this is the official term, but people seem to be using it, falling off the table, and appropriations are continuing forward pretty effectively. So I think there are still a handful of some big picture policy issues that need to be addressed. But again, I'm always glass half full, Madam President, but I feel like we could actually get this done before we go home again.
Madam President, will sponsor continue to yield?
Yield?
Yes.
The Senator yields.
Well, I'm glad to hear your glass half full, and we all, I think, are hopeful. But, you know, I've heard your folks, the folks on your side of the aisle, say that we'd rather have, you know, rather than a bad budget, we'd rather have a good budget so it doesn't necessarily have to be on time. But really, you know, what do you anticipate that's going to be in this budget that's going to be so much better that it couldn't have been negotiated and done on time? What's better that we are now so late, historically late, for this budget?
I'm not sure we are historically late, Madam President, because I've been here in August and done budgets in August, so I don't think we're anywhere near historical lateness, and I don't wish for us to ever do that again, thank you. And it is interesting because people do say they would rather have a good budget than an on-time budget, and it's an interesting question. I'd say it's in the eye of the beholder, because you and I each might have very different definitions of what's a good budget and what makes a budget better or not better than the original executive proposal. So I think that's a much longer discussion. I will highlight that I think the importance to the people of New York of redoing these extenders are that government is continuing to function. We are paying the workers. We are continuing to pay our debts. We are paying the bills. Government has not ceased to function because we are late in the budget. Now, interestingly, this year, and people seem to have forgotten pretty quickly, because the governor is allowed to submit her budget 2 weeks later, the first year after a election, she did submit it 2 weeks later. So technically, we're not as far behind as we think, because we had 2 weeks less before April 1st to negotiate and get done. So I actually think those first 2 weeks of being late were sort of putting us back on a normal schedule, bizarrely, but now we are a couple of weeks late. But again, for the people who may be out there listening and watching and making sure that government is continuing to function, it absolutely is, as long as we get this extender passed before noon today. So I don't wish to continue extenders. I can guarantee you the staff do not wish to continue extenders. But it is far, far better to have the extender option and continue to complete our negotiations and get to budget bills we are confident in, because we are not doing harm to the functioning of the state of New York on behalf of all of our constituents.
Madam President, sponsor, continue to yield.
Do you continue to yield?
I do.
Senator yields.
So notwithstanding the two-week mulligan that you've given yourself in this, I think we are certainly frustrated, because although we are continuing to limp along and our operations are running, I hear from folks every day that want to know what's going on, because so much of their budget, so much depends on what happens here in this budget being passed. So with that being said, you know, budgets are about budgets. They're about money. They're about what we're going to expend, what revenues are. It's clear that it's policy that's holding up this budget and not the finances of New York State. So with that being said, why are we discussing policy in the budget?
I like the question. Thank you very much, Madam President. Some people think we shouldn't do any policy in a budget. And some states have far, far less policy built into their budget documents. I would probably vote for less policy in our budgets, although it's impossible not to have some, because when you're appropriating money for programs, you're often creating programs at the same time or redesigning them. So I think it would be impossible to remove policy from our budgets. But I actually would agree with my colleague that perhaps there's just too much policy going into our budget document, and we could be working on those as freestanding bills and changing statutes. Ironically, being so tied up in budget being late, we have less time to be working on those statutes that I think all of us would like to see moved. Yes, if I was writing the executive budget, if I was queen for a day, which I am not, maybe I wouldn't have as much policy proposals in it as we have been given, but under our rules, or more like under a court case decision, that's Pataki v. Silver, which gave the governor such a disproportionate amount of the powers and authority when it came to what goes into a budget, what comes out, and what else can go in. This is the hand we have been dealt.
Madam President, on the bill.
Senator Borello on the bill.
I want to thank Senator Krueger again for those thoughtful responses, and I think we all appreciate the fact that we are now on our fifth extender, and the holdup indeed is policy. And I appreciate the fact that you agree we shouldn't have as much policy. I think that's really the holdup here. And, you know, that's part of the problem why most people don't feel that their government represents them in a transparent way, because we try to hide all of this policy in the budget. It's actually difficult for our staff to try and find that needle in the haystack when we talk about, for example, bail reform, and it ends up in a part of the budget that has absolutely nothing to do with criminal justice. You know, that's the kind of shell game that is played here in Albany, and quite frankly, you know, that's somewhat unique for New York State in a lot of ways, but it is the reason why people lack faith. And the people who depend on us the most to get this budget done, the people that deal with our most vulnerable citizens, people with disabilities, senior citizens, all those folks are waiting every day. And although a lot of our constituents don't know that the budget is late, the people that we need to supply critical funding and resources for, they do. And I urge everyone to move as quickly as possible to finalize this so the people that are dealing with the most vulnerable citizens in New York State have some assurance that their government does indeed work. Thank you, Madam President.
Senator Helming, why do you rise?
Thank you, Madam President. The sponsor will yield for a question.
Senator Krueger, do you yield?
Certainly.
Thank you, Senator Krueger. Through you, Madam Senator Krueger, I heard you make a comment to the effect that government continues to function as we pass these extenders. And Senator Brello just raised an excellent point that there are many organizations and agencies that are out there and they're struggling, waiting. And the fact that we haven't passed a budget, it is impacting them. I have heard over the last several days from several childcare providers, not-for-profit providers, who are really struggling right now. They depend upon the stabilization grant funding. I've heard in conversations with OCFS, I've heard to the stabilization grants referred to as lifelines for these not-for-profit childcare providers. Can you tell me if there's any funding or any resources in the extender that will help our child care providers?
Thank you. Sorry, I needed to double check something. Our understanding is stabilization grants are more like one-time grants, and that the child care providers can be submitting bills for reimbursement on their ongoing costs under their contracts. But I don't disagree with you that there are many groups out there hoping that they will see additional monies in the new fiscal year above and beyond what they were being paid under their ongoing contracts. In fact, I think I tried to add up sort of the master list of what everyone was asking for, and I had to sit down because it was, I think, about $40 billion of hopes and dreams that people were submitting to us, and I'm pretty sure they won't be getting all that. But yes, childcare providers are not getting any kind of new one-shot stabilization grants yet, until we resolve this budget.
Thank you. On the bill, Madam President.
Senator Helming, on the bill.
So this is very concerning to me. As I stated, I had a number of not-for-profit childcare centers reach out to me. Some have gone as far as closing down classrooms. I have another one that serves over 100 families, and they've maxed out credit cards to try and meet their payroll and their other financial obligations. They were waiting for the round three stabilization grants to be passed. And of course, as we just heard, that's not going to happen until the budget is approved. There isn't any more money left from round two funding that the OCFS can pass out to these child care providers. This is a real concern, not only to families into employers trying to get people to work, but also to children who, when their routine is disrupted, it has a negative impact. So I would urge the majority to do everything they can, that if we're back here again on Friday with another extender, we have something in it to help these providers. Personally, I hope we're not passing a sixth extender, that we're actually starting to work on the budget. Thank you, Madam President.
Senator Helming. Are there any other senators wishing to be heard? Senator Steck, why do you rise?
Thank you. If the sponsor would yield for a question, please.
A quick question, do you yield?
A quick question, I hope.
I will answer a quick question.
Thank you. Good morning, Senator Krueger. In previous discussion about the amount of policy that's in the budget with another colleague of ours, you made reference to the progress that had been made over the weekend and that some policy items that were under discussion have, quote, fallen off the table. I was just wondering if you could enlighten us and the 20 million New Yorkers what those items might be, since the budget's 24 days late and everyone's curious to know what's going on with the budget. Thank you.
I'm sorry, I don't have a master list, and I think quite a few of them have already hit the press. So I would say that the housing package of the governor is one of the items that she has pulled back on. I think there are a number of other items that she's already announced she's pulled back on. And I apologize that there's no others that are just jumping to my mind right now. But again, I think anything that is known has also already been shared through the press, because there are no secrets in this town and they're pretty good at tracking what's happening.
Madam President, the sponsor would yield for one quick follow-up.
Will you yield for a quick question?
That's a follow-up, yes.
Thank you, Senator Krueger. Can you give us an update on where we stand at this moment with bail reform, since that was the one that's been most talked about? I still think there's a cloud of uncertainty over what we're doing in criminal justice.
So I do not believe that has fallen off the table. I do believe that there are changes in criminal justice that will be part of the final budget bills. But it is not necessarily my bailiwick, so I do not actually have details I can share yet.
Thank you, Madam President.
Senator Steck. Senator Tedisco?
Sponsor, yield for a question.
Senator Krueger, will you yield for a quick question?
Yes.
I'm adding quick.
Senator Krueger,
We have the 12 o'clock deadline, sorry. Very quick question.
Over the years, there have been other budgets that have been late. And at that time, there were separate bodies here who were controlled by your side of the aisle, others were controlled by our side of the aisle. It seemed that Republicans blamed Democrats, Democrats blamed Republicans, but this is kind of different. Your party controls all sides of the aisle. Supermajority here, supermajority in the assembly. You've got the governor, the same affiliation for you. Whose fault is it that we're here going on 4 weeks late with a budget this time? Because it can't be our affiliation, because we don't control any part of the system here.
Well, we all ran for office and we're all the government, so I always look in the mirror every morning and say, now I'm part of the problem. And I think at a certain level, all of us are. We do not have a perfect system of government. Democracy is a delicate balance. Democracy, small d, not party affiliation. So we have not perfected how we get great budgets done on time each year.
Excuse me, Senator Tedisco. Senator Tedisco. Senator Tedisco. Are you asking Senator Krueger to yield? I don't think she was finished.
Last question. Very quickly, Senator Sanders has a bill to penalize the governor the way we're purportedly penalized, to delay her salary. Is that an indication that you and he and your conference believe she's responsible?
Oh, I have not had a discussion with my conference. I signed on to the bill, but I can't speak for anyone else. And it is 12 o'clock, Madam President, so I think I can't answer any more questions.
Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Krueger. Are there any other senators wishing to be heard? Seeing and hearing none, debate is closed. The secretary will ring the bell. Read the last section.
Section 17. This action take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce results.
Ayes 57.
The bill is passed. Senator Gianaris, that completes the reading of the controversial calendar.
At this point, we're going to stand at ease while we have respective party conferences. There will be an immediate meeting of the Democratic Conference in room 332. And please recognize Senator Lanza.
There'll be an immediate meeting of the Republican Conference in room 315.
The Senator stands at ease. There will be respective meetings of the Senate conferences. The Senate will return to order. Senator Gianaris.
Thank you, Madam President. At this time, can we return to the supplemental calendar, remove the lay aside that was placed temporarily on calendar 627, and take that bill up, please?
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 627, Senate Print 6454, Independent Redistricting Commission, enactment of state law.
Read the last section.
Section 6, action take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 627, voted in the negative, Senator Lanza. Aye 56, nays 1.
The bill is passed. Senator Gianaris, that completes the reading of today's calendar.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
Let me remind my colleagues we're going back into a Democratic conference upon adjournment, and on that I move to adjourn until tomorrow, Tuesday, April 25th at 3 p.m.
The Senate stands adjourned until tomorrow, April 25th at 3 p.m.